Everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's JKB Crochets. Today I'll be taking you through the halter neck tutorial. So for this project I'll be using a lightweight yarn. I'll be doubling my strands to achieve a middleweight yarn. So if you have a middleweight yarn, don't double, just use it straight away. I'll be using a 4.5 millimeter hook. I'll be using a pair of scissors as well. That's all I'll be using. So let's start this tutorial. Once again, please subscribe to my channel. I was so happy when you guys gave me 100 subscribers within last week. Thanks a lot, that's encouraging. So I'm going to start off by chaining 94 chains. Make a slip knot and chain one. So chain 94, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'll meet you when you have 94 chains. I'm back and I'm done with my 94 chains. So we're going to place a double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. 1, 2, 3, 4. In that fourth chain from the hook, place a double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it is. Place your double crochet there. Chain two. Place two double crochets in the next two chains, like in each stitch place a double crochet, and also in this next stitch place a double crochet. I'm using seagull yarn here. Now chain two, skip two stitches, 1, 2, and in the third stitch place a double crochet. Place a double crochet in the next stitch as well. Chain two, 1, 2, place a double crochet in the next two stitches. Here, one, also in the next stitch place a double crochet, chain two, place a double crochet, skip two stitches, and in the next 30 stitches skip two stitches, and in the next stitch place a double crochet. Now we're going to place double crochets in the next 29 stitches to have a total of 30 stitches. In the next 29 stitches, place a double crochet. So I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. I'm done with my 30 double crochets. So I'm going to chain two, yarn over. I'm going to skip two stitches, and in the third stitch, I'll place a double crochet. I'll place a double crochet in the next stitch as well. Chain two, place a double crochet in the next stitch, and in the next stitch as well. Here, chain two, skip two stitches, and place a double crochet in the third stitch. Skip two stitches, 1, 2, and place a double crochet here. So you're going to place double crochets in the next 29 stitches to have a total of 30 double crochets. Okay, I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. So I'm done with my other 30 double crochets. Chain two, yarn over, skip two stitches, 1, 2. And in the third stitch, place a double crochet. Place a double crochet in the next stitch as well. Chain two. Place a double crochet in the next two stitches. In each of the next two stitches. And also in the next stitch. So yarn over. Skip two stitches, 1, 2, Place a double crochet in this third stitch and also a double crochet in this next stitch. Chain two, place a double crochet in each of the next two stitches and also in the last stitch. This is, we are done with our first row. This is what we have for our first row. So we're going to start. Chain three, one, two, three. Turn your work, yarn over, place now we're going to be doing what we call a shell design. A shell design is two double crochets, chain two, two double crochets. It's what you're going to place here in this space. Two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets in that very space. That's what we call a shell design. Don't forget that. Chain, don't chain anything. Go to the next shell space and place a shell. This space and place a shell. Go straight to that space and place a shell. Two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets. Chain two, two more double crochets. There we are. I think this hook is slightly big. I'll be changing. Hope that doesn't affect you. I'll place it somewhere in the description that I used a 3mm hook because I found this yarn is too light. So yarn over, skip chain two, go and place a double crochet on each of the next 30 stitches. Yeah, this is the perfect hook for this. Place a double crochet on top of the next stitches and I'll meet you when you're done with your 30 double crochets. Next we're going to chain two. Chain two, place a double crochet in this shell space. Place two double crochets in this shell space, what we call a shell. Two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets in that very space. There we are. Chain two and place, we're going to work on our 30 double crochets. Place a double crochet on each of the stitches, in each of the next 30 stitches. So you should have a total of 30 double crochets. I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. So after chaining two, place a shell in this. I'm done with my 30. Place chain two. Place a shell in this chain two space. Two double crochets. Two double crochets. Chain two. Two more double crochets. That's our shell. Go straight to this space here, this last space, and place a shell as well. Two double crochets. Chain two. Two more double crochets. Don't forget to place one last double crochet here at the end, here in this last stitch on top. Place a double crochet. So chain three, one, two, three, turn your work and you're going to start on our third row. Place a shell in this shell space. The shell is two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets. That's a shell. Place a shell in the next shell space here. This is a shell space. Place two double crochets, a shell. Chain two, two more double crochets. That's what we call a shell. Don't forget that. Chain two. Every after the two shells, you have to chain two. And place the 30 double crochets on top of the next stitches. One, two, three. Continue until you're done with the 30 double crochets and I'll meet you there. After the 30 double crochets, chain two, place a shell in this next shell space. This is a shell space. Place a shell. 2 double crochets. Chain 2. 2 more double crochets. And that's a shell. Chain 2. Place the 30 double crochets on top of the previous row. One, two, three, four. I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. I'll meet you here. After the 30 double crochets, chain 2. Place a shell in these next shell spaces. Place a shell here and also a shell here. Then place one last double crochet here on top of this double crochet. Then chain 3 and turn. Now for row 4, let me meet you there when I'm done with my third row. Now that I'm done with my third row, I've chained 3, turn your work. Now for the fourth row, it's going to be similar to the previous row. Place a shell here in this shell space, a shell here in this shell space, chain 2, place the 30 double crochets, chain 2, place a shell in this shell space, chain 2, place the 30 double crochets, chain 2, place a shell here, chain 3. And I'll meet you on row 5 and I'll show you what to do. Done with the 4 rows. Now we're going to start working on one side of the cup. We're going to first concentrate on this side. Then after, we shall concentrate on this side. Now for row 5, chain 3. Chain 3, go into the shell space with a shell. 2 double crochets, chain 2. 2 more double crochets. Go into the next shell space with a shell. Here, with a shell. 2 double crochets. Chain 2. 2 more double crochets. Chain 2. Place the 30 double crochets on these 30 double crochet stitches. And I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. I'm done with my 30 double crochets. Now I'm going to chain 2, yarn over. We want to divide this part from this part. Yarn over, go to this space here between these 2 double crochets and place a shell between those 2 double crochets. Place 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Go to this shell space, this actual shell space, and place 1 double crochet. We're done with our row 5 for this side. So chain 3, turn your work. Row 6, place a shell in the shell space. Chain 2, 2 more double crochets. No more chaining 2, yarn over, go straight to this, 30 double crochets and place a stitch on each stitch. Place a double crochet on each stitch. I'll meet you when you're done with the 30 double crochets. Now after here, chain 2. Place a shell here and a shell here. Don't forget to place this last double crochet on top of this last double crochet in the previous row. Chain 3, turn your work. Place a shell here, and I'll meet you on 7. Then I've placed a shell here and a shell here in the shell space. Now I'm going to row. You have chain 2, yarn over. We're going to start something different to form a cup shape. We're going to be reducing. Yarn over, chain 2, yarn over. Go to this first stitch here, insert your hook, pull through. You have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. You have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, insert your hook, pull through. You have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. You have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all. That's how you're going to be reducing for the first row, once beginning a row. Yarn over, continue placing normal double crochets in the next stitches across. I'll meet you when you're done with these stitches and you have 3 stitches remaining. I'll meet you when you have only 3 stitches remaining here. I'm back. I'm done with the 25 double crochets here. I'm remaining with 3 double crochets, as you can see. So I'll yarn over, go into the third last stitch, place my hook there, pull through, We have 3 loops on our hook, pull through 2. We have 2 loops on our hook, yarn over, insert into the next second last stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 3 loops on your hook, pull through all. That's putting 2 double crochets together. Yarn over, place a double crochet in the last stitch. Go straight to this shell space and place a shell. So double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Don't forget to place that last double crochet here. We are done with our row 7. For row 8, chain 3, turn your work. Place a shell here in the shell space. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. We go straight here on this first stitch here. And we're going to start reducing again. Yarn over, you have 3 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 2 loops, yarn over, go to the next stitch here. Now when we put the two double crochets together, it becomes 1 stitch. Place your hook in the next stitch, yarn over, you have 4 loops, pull through 2. You have 3 loops, pull through all. Continue placing normal double crochets in the next stitches across until you have 3 more stitches remaining, and I'll show you again how we reduce. Okay, so I'm done with the 23 stitches here after the double crochet together here, 2 together. Yarn over, remaining with 3 stitches. Insert into the third last stitch. You have 3 loops, pull through 2. You have 2 loops, yarn over. Go into the second last stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 3 loops on your hook, pull through all. Place a double crochet in the very last stitch, a normal double crochet in this last stitch. There we are. Chain 2 and place the shells in a shell. Place a shell in the shell space and also place a shell in the shell space. Chain 3 and I'll meet you on the next row when I've turned like this. I've chained 3. I'm done with my row 8. Turn my work. We're going to start on row 9. So row 9 is what you're going to do for the next 13 rows, until we have 13 rows. So what you're going to do, pay attention on this row so that I can leave you and you continue the next rows on your own until you have 13 rows. Okay, it's what we've done on this last row, but let me show you again. Place a shell in this shell space, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Place a shell in this shell space as well, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Chain 2, reduce here, do our reduction here, insert your hook, pull through, you have 3 loops, pull through 2, you have 2 loops, yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through, you have 4 loops, pull through 2, you have 3 loops, pull through all. Continue to the next stitches, placing 1 double crochet in each, and I'll meet you when you have 3 more stitches here. I've reached my, I'm remaining with 3 more double crochets, 3 more stitches, sorry, 1, 2, 3. Yarn over, go into the second last stitch, pull through. You have 3 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over, go to the second last stitch, insert your hook, pull through. You have 4 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 3 loops on your hook, pull through all 3. Yarn over, place 1 last double crochet here. And there you are. Yarn over, go straight in the shell space and place a shell. 2 double crochets. Chain 2. 2 more double crochets. Place 1 last double crochet here on top of this last double crochet. And this is what we have. with our 9 rows. Chain 3, turn your work. Now we are going to go into the shell space immediately with a shell. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Now go straight into the first. I've taught you how to reduce before in the previous rows. Yarn over, go straight to this stitch here. Insert your hook, pull through. You have 3 loops, pull through 2, you have 2 loops. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops, pull through 2, you have 3 loops, pull through all. Continue with no more double crochets. I already showed you how to reduce. Now you're going to continue with this until you have a total of 13 rows. Okay, you're going to continue until you have a total of 13 rows, and I'll meet you there. Don't forget to always reduce here, and when you have 3 more stitches remaining, you reduce the shells. Don't forget them. I'll meet you when you have a total of 13 rows. And I'm done with my 13 rows. This is how it looks like. You can see we've got our shape, our cup shape. This is where I've reached. So for row 14, you're going to be doing something different. Chain 3, turn your work, place a shell in this shell space here, 2 double crochets, chain 2, place 2 more double crochets in that very space. Yarn over, skip this next stitch here. Go into the next stitch here, and yarn over, pull through 2. You have 2 loops, yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops, pull through 2. You have 3 loops, pull through all. Yarn over, go to the next 4 stitches and place double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 3, and 4. Then we're going to reduce again in the middle here. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through 2. Yarn over, go to the next stitch. You have 4 loops, pull through 2. You have 3 loops, pull through all. Place a double crochet in the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Reduce 1 more time, yarn over, you have 3 loops, pull through 2, yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through, you have 4 loops, pull through 2, pull through 3. So we've reduced here, here, and here. Don't work anything in the next stitch here, just chain 2 and place your shell here. Into 2 more double crochets. Place a shell also here in this stitch, in this space. Chain 2. Please don't forget to subscribe and follow me on my IG JKB Crochets, on my Facebook page as well, JKB Crochets, on my TikTok as well, JKB Crochets. All my social media accounts have the same photo as my Facebook, as my YouTube profile photo. So we are done with 14 rows so far. For row 15, chain 3, turn your work, place a shell here in the shell space, chain 2, place 2 more double crochets here. Once again, thanks for the 100 subscribers. Go to this place here and place a shell space. Place 2 more double crochets. Now we're going to be doing something different here. Now I'm on row 15. I've placed here my shell, row 15. Chain 3. 1, 2, 3, yarn over, we're going to skip 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. I need a 5th stitch, place a double crochet. Also in the next stitch, place a double crochet. Also in the next stitch, place a double crochet. chain three again, 1, 2, 3, yarn over, go straight to the shell space and place a shell, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, place 1 last double crochet here at the end, and there we are. For the next row, chain 3, turn your work, go in the shell space with a shell, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. This time round you're going to chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, yarn over, go on top of the middle stitch and place a double crochet, chain 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, place a shell here and a shell here, then place 1 double crochet here at the end. I'll meet you there. So for row 17, I'm done with row 16. For row 17, chain 3, turn your work, yarn over, go straight to this shell space and place a shell, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, go to the next shell space and place a shell, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, go to the last shell space here, go straight to this shell space and place a shell as well, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, place 1 last double crochet here on top of this double crochet, and there we are. This is our work. Now what you're going to continue is going to be so easy. It's like what we've done here in the previous row. Chain 3, turn your work, place a shell in this shell space, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, place a shell in this next shell space, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, go into the next shell space here and place 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Plus 1 last double crochet here at the end. Don't forget that double crochets. Chain 3. Place a shell here, a shell here, a shell here, chain 3. Place a double crochet here, chain 3. We're going to repeat that until we have a total of 6 rows. This should be 6 rows. These 3 double crochets should be 6 rows. I'll meet you when you have the 6 rows and I'll show you what to do next. You're going to start working on this other side of the cup. So what you're going to do, turn your work like this, attach your yarn, make a slip knot, chain 1, place here, go here in this space. I've placed 3 double crochets, I mean a chain of 3 in this space, shell space, and it counts as a double crochet. Yarn over, go to this space here and place a shell, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets, that, chain 2, sorry, don't chain 2, for the next rows you're not going to chain 2, go straight to this space and place a double crochet, Continue across, placing a double crochet in each of these 30 stitches, and I'll meet you when you're done there. After the 30 double crochets, chain 2 and continue placing a shell here in this shell space, a shell here, place the last double crochet here, turn your work, chain 3, place the double crochet here, place shell space, and also place another shell in this shell space. For row 6, we shall also do the same thing we've done on the previous row. Chain 2, place a double crochet in the next stitch. Place double crochets throughout the entire row to have a total of 30 double crochets. After, I'll meet you here. I'm done with the 30 double crochets for row 6. So I'll go straight to this shell space and place a shell. In the next row is where we're going to start reducing. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Don't forget to place that last double crochet here. Don't forget that double crochet here. Chain 3, turn your work, place a shell here, and I'm going to remind you one more time how to reduce here. Place a shell in the shell stitch, in the shell space. Chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Yarn over, go to the next stitch. You know we are no longer going to chain 2. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through. You have 2 loops. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops. Pull through 2. You have 3 loops. Pull through all. Continue the same thing. We are just mirroring what we did here to this other side. I'm just reminding you how to reduce before I leave you to continue on your own until you have the exact thing we have on the other side. I'll meet you when you're done with these double crochets, and I remind you one more time how to reduce here. Now I'm remaining with 3 stitches. Yarn over, go to the second last stitch, insert your hook, pull through. You have 3 loops, pull through 2. You have 2 loops, yarn over, go to the second last stitch, insert your hook, pull through. You have 4 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 3 loops on your hook, pull through all. Place a normal double crochet in this last stitch, chain 2, and continue normally. Place a shell here, chain 2, don't forget a shell is double, 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. Go straight to this next shell and place a shell here, 2 double crochets. I think this tutorial is easy, isn't it? It's very easy and smooth. Go to the last double crochet and place a double crochet here to this space, and place 1 last double crochet. Chain 3, turn your work. Now you're going to place a shell here, go straight here to this next shell space and place a shell. Continue to reduce here, continue with normal double crochets. You have 3 stitches remaining. Continue what we did on this side. It's the same thing you have to do on this side. So I'll meet you when you're done with this, when you are done with these six rows of shells here. I'll meet you there. I'm done with both my sides here. I've not yet cut my yarn. So next we are going to here. We want to create something that will connect here to this other cup. Place your last double crochet here. Now you're going to chain 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. You're going to connect to this other side with a slip stitch. Here, make sure you slip stitch here at this place. Slip stitch. After your slip stitch, we are going to go on slip stitching until we reach here and we chain 28. Slip stitch in this next space, slip stitch here, slip stitch here. You go on just placing slip stitches. just slip stitches until you get here at the end. Oops. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I would really love to see what you guys have done. In case you've done it, tag me on any social media platform, JKB Crochets. I would love to see what you guys have done a lot. I would really want to see what you guys have done. Those who did the shorts, I saw some, I was tagged in some posts. I really appreciate what you guys do. Now I've reached my last stitch here after slip stitching. I'm going to slip chain 28 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. After, I'll chain one more and cut. I've cut. So I'm going to go on this other side here and place my hook, get my yarn. Make a slip knot, chain one, and connect. We're going to chain 28 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll be back when you're done with the 28. I'm done with the 28 stitches. Chain 3 more stitches. 1, 2, 3, and double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. See that? We want to create something like this. This is going to be our neck, our cleavage rather, and this will be the one going around our neck, the halter neck. I've placed a double crochet in the next stitch. This is how it was. Place a double crochet in the fourth chain from the hook. Those are two double crochets. Yarn over. Chain two. Go to the next two stitches and place a double crochet in each. And also in the next stitch. There. This is how we start our shell. Yarn over. Skip two stitches and in the third stitch place a double crochet. Also in the next stitch place a double crochet. Chain two. Skip, place two double crochets in the next two stitches and also in the next stitch. That's what we have. Chain two, skip two stitches and place a double crochet. I beg your pardon. Yarn over, skip two stitches and in the third stitch place a double crochet. Place a double crochet in the next stitch. Chain two, place a double crochet in the next two stitches and also in the next stitch. We have so far, these are shells, 1, 2 shells, 3. Yarn over, skip two stitches, place a double crochet in the third stitch and also in the next stitch. Chain two, skip two stitches and place a double crochet in the third stitch, in the next stitch rather. Hold on. After chain two, go to the next two stitches and place a double crochet in each and also in the next stitch. We have four shells so far. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yarn over, skip 2 stitches, and in the 3rd stitch place a double crochet. And also in the next stitch, chain 2, place a double crochet in the next 2 stitches, and also in the next stitch. We are done with our 5 shells. Those are 5 shells we have. Yarn over, go straight to this shell space and place a shell. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Yarn over, go to the next shell space and place a shell. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. That's what we call a shell. Go to the next shell space and also place a shell. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Yarn over, skip all this and go to this first double crochet here and place a double crochet, and also in the next stitch place a double crochet. Chain 2, place a double crochet in the next 2 stitches. Also in the next stitch, yarn over, skip 2 stitches and place a double crochet in the next stitch. Place a double crochet in the next stitch as well. Chain 2, place 2 double crochets in the next 2 stitches. We have 2 shells so far here in the neck part. We have to have 3. Yarn over, skip 2 stitches, and in the 3rd and in the next stitch, place a double crochet. And also in the next stitch, chain 2, place a double crochet in the next stitch. Place a double crochet in the next stitch as well. So we're going to continue. Yarn over, we are done with the 3 shells in that area, neck. 1, 2, 3. Yarn over, skip 2 stitches. No, go straight to this shell space and place a shell. 2 double crochets. After, you also go to this shell space and place a shell. This shell space, you place a shell. I'll meet you here on this line. Now you're going to go on here. We also want to place what we did here, this side. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, place to the 1st stitch, place a double crochet, and also the next stitch, place a double crochet. Chain 2, place a double crochet in the next 2 stitches. Double yarn can really stress. It's nothing to do. Yarn over, go to the next. Yarn over, skip 2 stitches and go to the next stitch with a double crochet. Go to the next stitch with a double crochet as well. Chain 2, go to the next 2 stitches and place a double crochet in each. Those are 2 shells. Yarn over, go skip 2 stitches and go to the next stitch with a double crochet. Go to the next stitch as well with a double crochet. Chain 2, go to the next two stitches with double crochets, even in this next one with a double crochet. We have three, yarn over, skip two stitches, go to the next one with a double crochet, go to the next one as well with a double crochet, chain two, go to the next one with a double crochet, go to the next one with a double crochet. We have four, yarn over, skip two stitches, go to the next one with a double crochet, go to the next one with a double crochet, chain two, go to the last two with a double crochet in each, and we are done with this row. This is how it should look like for everyone. This, we're going to chain three, turn our work. For the next two rows, it's going to be very easy, and I will leave you to do this on your own. It's just placing a shell in a shell. Go to this space, you see this is the shell, that chain two space is the shell. Place two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets. That's the shell. This time you should be knowing what the shell is. So I want you to leave, I want to leave you to go on your own. Place a shell in the next shell space here, a shell here, a shell. Just place shells, don't chain anything. A shell, a shell, a shell here until we reach the end here. Here, after placing the shell, chain three, turn your work and continue. I'll meet you when you're done with the three rows and I'll show you how mine will look like. With my three rows, this is it for the three rows. We're going to now start working on. Now, for, let me show you how we close this. This is how we close it. This is our neck area. You get a button here and you place it here inside. You place it inside so that when you put it here, you close it like this. It doesn't even show outside. And this part should also be inside when you're wearing. You just get a button, place it here, and it can enter into any of these. Make sure you get a big button, then get a small button because it will easily move out. I'll show you my button at the end. So we're going to start working on this downer side. Let me attach my yarn. Make a slip knot, chain one. I'm going to start here. I've turned my work. Go into this double crochet, between these two double crochets. Place your yarn. Chain three. We're going to go in this shell space and directly place a shell here, in this shell space. Place two double crochets. Chain two. Two more double crochets. To this next shell space and place a shell as well. Two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets. Yarn over. Skip these stitches here and go straight here on these stitches and place a double crochet. Chain one. Now you're going to be skipping two stitches. Chain one, skip two stitches, and in the third stitch, place a shell. Now for this case, it's going to be something different. We're going to place the shell in one stitch. Now you place two double crochets in the very stitch. Chain two, two more double crochets in that very stitch. And that's a shell, see? Chain one, skip two stitches, and in the third stitch, place a double crochet. Chain one, skip two stitches, and in the third stitch, place a shell. Place two double crochets in one stitch. Chain, place two double crochets. Chain two, Let's do more double crochets in that very stitch. Chain one, skip two stitches, and in the next stitch place a double crochet. Chain one, skip two stitches, and in the next stitch place a shell. This is going to be our routine for the whole of this entire row. Okay, so I want you to continue. I'll meet you here and I'll guide you here. So we've reached here. What you're going to do, chain one, skip two stitches, and in this third stitch place a double crochet. This next stitch, chain one, skip two stitches, place a double crochet in this stitch, chain one, go straight into the shell space and place a shell, the shell space, and place two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets. Chain one, skip these two stitches and go straight here with one double crochet. Chain one, skip two stitches, go here with a shell, two double crochets. Chain two, two more double crochets. Okay, that. So yarn over, chain one, skip two stitches, place a double crochet in the next stitch, chain one, skip two stitches, place a double crochet in the next, and sorry, a shell, two more double crochet, a double crochet, chain two, place two more double crochets. So you're going to continue like that till we finish here. Place a shell here in this shell space. Chain two. Place two more double crochets. Chain one. Place a double crochet here on top. Chain one. Place a shell here in this shell space. So that's our repetition. I'll meet you here at the end and I'll show you how we end. It's the usual placing a double crochet in the last stitch. But I'll meet you there and show you. In these places, this side, don't chain anything. Even this side, don't chain anything. Just go straight there with a last double crochet here on top of this last double crochet. Chain three, turn your work, go straight to this chain space and place a shell. So that's going to be our procedure for the rest of the rows. Chain one, sorry, don't chain, sorry, forgive me, don't chain. Just go straight here and place your shell. Chain two, place. Here, when you're going to the chain one, you chain one also. And you place a double crochet on top. Chain one, continue with these shells. So this side, you chain one, make a shell, chain one, place a shell in the shell space, chain one. Place a double crochet, chain one, place a shell in a shell place, chain one, place a double crochet like that. This side, don't chain ones, this side and this side. So you're going to continue until you have, personally, I think I'll make 7 or 8 rows. You can increase to however many rows you want. So me, I want a coverage of 8 rows or 7 rows. If you don't want, if you want to stop here, it's very fine. You will meet me when I'm starting on the straps. But those who want to continue, please, let's go on with our rows, with our shell rows. I'll meet you when you're done. I'm back. I'm done with this side. This is our string. I mean our strap. It's the same thing we're going to do this other side. These are our straps which are going to tie at the back. So what you do, get your yarn, make a slip knot. Attach your yarn here at this last stitch here in that corner. Chain three, 1, 2, 3. Place a double crochet in the next space. You place a double crochet here, place a double crochet in this joint here, that little space. Place a double crochet in the next space here. Place a double crochet here. Place a double crochet in this next space. We have to have a total of 9. So far you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Place a double crochet here. In that joint. I'll meet you when you're done here. I've reached here. I've chained one. I've placed a double crochet here. Chain 1. Go straight to this shell space. And place a shell. Chain 2. Place 2 more double crochets. Chain 1. Sorry, don't chain anything. Just go straight to this shell space and place a shell. Chain 2. There we are. Place 1 more double crochet here in the end. In the last stitch. Chain 3. Now we're going to start working on this other side. Placing shells down. Place a shell here in this shell space. Chain 2, place 2 more double crochets. Place a shell here straight away. Chain 2, 2 more double crochets. Chain 1. Place a double crochet on top here. Chain 1. Place the shell here. Then place a double crochet in this next joint. Then after that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more double crochet here. Chain 3. Turn your work. Place a double crochet in the next stitch. A double crochet in the next space. And double crochet in the next stitch. A double crochet in the next stitch. A double crochet in the next stitch. And a double crochet in the next stitch. You have to have 9. A double crochet in the next stitch. And one double crochet in the very last stitch. You have to have 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Chain 3. Turn your work. Place a double crochet in the next stitch. Next stitch. Next stitch. Next stitch. Next stitch. Next stitch. Now we have three remaining stitches. Yarn over, insert your hook, pull through. We have 3 loops, pull through 2. Yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through. You have 4 loops, pull through 2. You have 3 loops, yarn over, go to the very last stitch, pull through. You have 5 loops on your hook, pull through 2. You have 4 loops, pull through all. Chain 3, turn your work, yarn over, go to the next stitch here, place your hook, pull through, you have 2 loops, yarn over, go to the next stitch, you have 4 loops, pull through 2, pull through all. Go to this next stitch, go to the next stitches and place just double crochets. And in the last stitch, double crochet, chain 3, turn your work, place a normal double crochet in the next stitch, place 1 double crochet in the next stitch. We're going to start reducing again. 1, yarn over, go to the next stitch, pull through, we have 4 loops, pull through 2. Yarn over, go to the last stitch. You have 5 loops, pull through 2, pull through all. Chain 3, turn your work, turn. Chain 3, we have 3 stitches remaining. Go to the last stitch and place a double crochet. On top of the last stitch and place a double crochet. Now we're going to start making a string, like a string which will go around our back. Chain 3, go to this very space and place a double crochet. Chain 3, go to the previous space here and place a double crochet in that space. Chain 3, place a double crochet in that very space. Chain 3, place a double crochet in this space. So you're going to continue like that until you have a total of 30 like this. Chain 3, previous space. They're going to be looking like this. They are pretty, right? So you're going to repeat this until you have something like this, this side. 30. I have less here, but I want you to have 30. So when you're done, it can be like this. Let me adjust my camera so that when you're done, you have something like this. This you can tie this behind your back. You can tie that behind your back and you place a button here. So that's it. I'm done. Don't forget to weave in these ends. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to JKB Crochets. Visit my IG and you see how this top is worn. You see the back view very well on my IG. See you next time. Thank you for watching.